What a decade. The World War was over and kids were having fun again. Lots of them were dancing the Charleston. It was the Jazz Age. Flaming youth, excitement, change, and fragile prosperity. Words like that describe a decade of change defined by complex post-war attitudes. These are the 1920s, the Roaring Twenties. The 1920s ushered in a welcome but uneasy post-war peace. Xenophobia, fear of foreigners, grew out of hostile encounters with enemy nations. Fears of the Russian Bolsheviks, sabotage, and the communist takeovers colored American popular culture. Racial fear and pride on the home front was driven home through an active Ku Klux Klan, just as African Americans began to assert their common identity. Prohibition introduced a new brand of turmoil to the decade, growing out of the popular religious thinking of the day. With the so-called evils of drink officially outlawed, crime, gang activity, bootlegging, and racketeering became widespread and drinking actually increased. Prohibition, often called the noble experiment, was repealed through a constitutional amendment. Finally, stock market speculation leading to the crash of 1929 typified the turmoil in America. People were buying stocks on margin or credit and paying only part of the fee. There were no regulations, so this got out of hand. Its effects were far-reaching and devastating to nearly every income bracket, effectively ending the so-called Roaring Twenties. Beginning in the 1910s, with America at war and urban industry suffering at home, thousands of black citizens began migrating north to fill jobs created by the war to begin new lives. As a result, the North saw an increase in black urban populations by about 20% from 1910 to 1930. Cities such as Chicago, New York, Detroit, and Cleveland saw the largest increases. Some companies, namely railroads, even went so far as to pay relocation expenses for some workers. The Great Migration didn't sit well with Southern plantation and business owners, some of whom attempted to court blacks into staying, even resorting to violent intimidation tactics such as following their former employees north to beat or threaten them into returning. But the Great Migration continued through the Great Depression, leveling off during the Second World War. There was trouble before and after the 20s, so why did this decade get a nickname, the Roaring Twenties? Protected by overall post-war prosperity and optimism, most urban Americans were not honest about their darker sides of life. These high national spirits were brought on by a number of things, especially a lot of wartime goods, which spelled an industrial boom after the war. High tariffs, taxes on imports, made American products like cars, telephones, cookers, and refrigerators more readily available. Those high tariffs made American-made products more affordable. Food was inexpensive due to oversupply and a diminishing foreign demand. It appeared that the national economy was experiencing a boom, but not based on sound economic principles. The Roaring Twenties also marked a period of great entertainment through the Jazz Age, radio stations, speakeasies, illegal taverns that let people in if they knew a code to get in, and cinema, first silent films, then talkies. Thank you. The Harlem Renaissance refers to a period of time from the close of World War I through the Great Depression, when a number of talented black artists and writers produced a wealth of ideas, forging new paths in identity and autonomy. A common theme for the Harlem Renaissance was marginality, which means living on the fringe of society. The popular music of the Harlem Renaissance was the blues. And Marcus Garvey led a movement to establish an African nation state. This was also when W.E.B. Du Bois coined his notion of two-ness. In his words, "One ever feels his two-ness, an American, a Negro, two souls, two thoughts, two unreconciled strivings, two warring ideals in one dark body, whose dogged strength alone keeps it from being torn asunder." Besides Du Bois, personalities of note during the movement were poet Langston Hughes, writer County Cullen, author Zora Neale Hurston, actress-dancer Josephine Baker, and jazz trumpeter Louis Armstrong. American women in the early 20th century took on a gradual shift from homemaking into various public arenas, beginning with the dawn of the suffrage movement in the late 1800s. No longer being content to merely serve husband and family, women of the 1920s began to adopt individuality. That individuality was expressed in the workplace, in athletics, in the arts, in fashion, in higher education, and in suffrage, the right to vote. The movement wasn't met with unanimous support in this country. Conservative religious groups and the KKK rallied against the concept of the new woman. But the movement grew strong and was validated by Congress with the passage of the 19th Amendment to the Constitution, granting women the right to vote. Although teens of the 20s listened to the radio, that's when television was invented. For teenagers, the 1920s were a time of dynamic change and social upheaval, a shift from silent films to talkies, new ways of looking at things, population movement prompting racial backlash, the growth of the women's rights, cosmic highs followed by numbing lows, a decade of great prosperity which set the stage for the economic despair to come in the 1930s. Next time on Snapshot, the Great Depression and the run-up to a war more destructive than the war to end all wars. For Snapshot, I'm Craig Marbury.
Oh, the shark has pretty teeth, dear, and he shows them a pearly white, just a jackknife has back heat, dear, and he keeps it out of sight. When the shark bites with his teeth, dear, scarlet billows start to spread.